Welcome to another episode of Wintergatan Wednesdays, and here it is business as usual. As you can see, I am trying out yet another lifting mechanism. It's a conveyor belt ratchet system combined. That's basically the mechanism. Slow-mo rolling.
In the last week's video, I built a ratchet marble lifting system, and in that video I said this.
Instead I came up with this, a ratchet lifting system. This system really have the ability to lift 8 marbles per crank turn.
That was all wrong. That ratchet system and the way it's driven only lifts 4 marbles per crank turn, and in this episode I'm going to replace it with something better, and I'm also going to explain why we need 8 marbles per crank turn. I thought I'd start with explaining why we need to lift 8 marbles per crank turn. Do you remember this test music I made to explain the magnet MIDI music system? And just to repeat, every click here is one crank turn. Turn, 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 right? So if we have a busy pattern on the vibraphone like this, you can already see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4 notes. That means that we need 4 marbles per crank turn to only to play this. But the Marble Machine X has more instruments than the vibraphone, so if we add a simple snare, offbeat like that, we're up to 9 marbles per 2 crank turns. If we then continue, add a simple kick drum, and then we add a hi-hat on top of that, start to see here now, 7 marbles for that, 7, 6, 7. But this pattern is really simple. If we make a more complicated kick drum pattern, you see, we're already up to 8 marbles per crank turn. So this is drums and vibraphone, but we also have the bass of the Marble Machine X. So with a very busy vibraphone pattern, we exceed 8 marbles per crank turn. Here we have 4, 7, and 11 marbles per crank turn. So the Marble Machine will be able to play this for some time because it has a lot of marbles stored upstairs, but it won't be able to sustain it for 5 minutes. When I make a really busy vibraphone pattern, I need to keep the drum pattern a little bit less busy. Coffee, what would we do without coffee, huh? So, as you can see, if we only had 4 marbles per crank turn, we would only be able to play either only this, or like only this, or only this. But if we can get 8 marbles per crank turn, we will be able to play almost something like this. So that's why it's so important. Okay, let's do some prototyping to solve this problem. I started with some spring cleaning of my workshop and I built a weld cart slash RoboWars contestant. The draw for Sir Darthalot was a little bit tough. He's meeting this old Tony's welding cart in round one, so we'll see.
What I have to measure with this prototype is the time for the marbles needed to go in there, because this will move extremely fast. It will move boom, 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 boom. So this is the improved prototype with some changes, and see if we can get up to marble speed with that. I have the slow-mo camera set up. The only thing I need now is the marbles. So let's go over here and look. And of course, the one box I need is guarded by a demon. I love animal, but these long leg things, I have to convince it that this is the wrong box to sit on. Hello, my friend. Can I please take my marbles? Whoa! Okay, he went there. Good choice, my friend. So, I'm going to take the marbles. And we can start the test. We have bigger openings, more like the CAD model. We have shimmed the openings so the marble cube won't rock back and forth as much, being pushed back and forth. I have a new ratchet that's better placed. I'm gonna try to max this one out. Let's analyze the slow-mo. And 1. 17 divided by 25. 0.68. 4 strokes divided on 0.68 seconds equals 5.8 marbles per second times 60. This was 352 BPM. Actually, that's some nice headroom. Yay!
This proves that the marbles loads fast enough in this method for playing music up to 200 BPM. And in the prototype I'm using 1 row of marbles, but in the real version we have 8 marbles. So now I need a way to divide all the marbles onto 8. So if you remember, we CADded a divide by 8 swing. Tobias Miedebrand from Gothenburg has sent me the first 3D print of that one. And here I am adjusting the weight nut on the backside to really make the swing tip exactly when it has 8 marbles on it. I tapped an M8 hole in the plastic and I used this lock nut to lock the bolt into place. And this really worked well. You can adjust this with very high precision to fall exactly when I want it to fall. But I realized that this swing is too slow because the conveyor belt can lift 8 marbles fast like that. And the swing can't handle that high marble pressure. So I needed another way to divide by 8. So I've been prototyping another system. I've been trying this, I've been trying that.
What I come up with is this. To divide one single row onto eight just before the conveyor belt. This seems to be very reliable. So if I now lift these marbles.
The marbles come into the ring gear from the planetary gear set, the blue line there, and they come in this new exit thing here that has quite complicated geometry, but I think this will work great. It attaches to the main frame here, as you can see. I added some text to this 3D printed part here, just for fun. The marbles come in this thing. They get split up onto the four channels, like I talked about last week, over the big demagnetizing wheel. The magnets are not going to be colored, it's just for symbolism. The marbles then, I'm not really done with this, it's sketches. The marbles then get collected into one row by this loft command I used to create this shape here. And then they go into this. And this is one of the most complicated things that I've ever CADed, because the geometries on these eight slopes are all individual. So they have a 5-degree slope seen from this direction, but they also have a 5-degree slope seen from this direction. They're all individual from the start and need to end up at the same spot in the end. So that was a little bit complicated. This works exactly like the marble divider. The channels that are full will skip the marbles, and the marbles will roll into the empty channels. And then they will be lifted up by this, the conveyor belt system. And the cool thing is, so I found this inspiration from a YouTube video for like some kind of industrial solutions for nuclear plants and recycling stations, where they use these chain links. And it was actually seeing that video that got me into understanding how I can build a marble conveyor belt that is efficient and looks good. So each chute that holds the marbles has a gear tooth shape. So up here, they turn into a gear drive, and the chain links is also fitting in here between the gear, as you can see here. And the cool thing is that this conveyor belt is not driven by these gears. It's not driven by a rotating mechanism. This conveyor belt is driven by the two pistons. These two pistons will move up and down with 40 millimeters travel. So just as you can see here, the right piston here is connected to half of the fister steps, and the left piston is connected to the other half. And I also implemented a spring tension mechanism here to help the pistons fight gravity a little bit. And on this side, we're gonna have ratchets. They are not sketched in this design yet, but they are coming out to the left side here, and they will go inside this conveyor belt here, and the ratchets will lift the chutes themselves. Every chute will whoop. So there's several things that is very, very good with this design. We're losing very little height. If we look at it straight from the side like this, let me put on orthographic and not perspective, and then we have a really flat view like this. So you can see that this is the top of the marbles, and down here where they're picked up is just 5 centimeters or something. And then we've done a lot with 5 centimeter fall height. We demagnetized the marbles and we routed them around and back. And if we look from the front of the machine, we are actually not going out that far to the left with this design. This conveyor belt reminds me of the snake, rattle and roll game, which I loved, when you climb the waterfall, you know, in the like world 7, super difficult. The marbles are like climbing the snake, rattle and roll system. So when these marble shuttles reaches the top, it will tip over, and the marbles will then roll on the backside on the chute that was before them. So if you see the structure here, is that the marbles will start to roll on this surface, so to speak. It's right under the marbles on this one. So they will roll on the swing that was before them and roll off into some tracks that I did not design yet. So that's the idea right now. I think this is very viable because I've done a lot of prototyping to get to this point. So when I built the first machine, I only made videos when I was done with parts, and I was regretting afterwards that I didn't show all mistakes and all the changed designs and stuff. And the way I'm making the videos now, update every week, you really get to follow how I go into dead ends and how I try to dig myself out of them. Thanks so much for watching. I'm editing these videos nowadays a little bit with shoot from the hip attitude. I hope you like it. I hope there's some kind of cohesion. Have a great day, everyone, and see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesday.